A swaying, enthusiastic, all-ticket capacity crowd on the baseball ground for the first Division One game between Derby County and Nottingham Forest for 65 years. The Derby, who proved themselves one of the country's most entertaining and enterprising sides, have slipped a little of late, winning but two and losing four of their last six games. Nevertheless, they field their usual team, and in their 12 are two former Nottingham Forest players, Frank Wignall, the substitute, and Alan Hinton, their match-winning number 11. And Nottingham Forest find goal scoring pretty difficult, and they're the First Division champions draw specialist. 11 of their 21 games have been drawn, and in those 21 games they've scored but 23 goals. But today they welcome back, after 6 weeks of suspension, Bob Chapman, their number 4. So they're hoping that his return is going to coincide with their fourth win of the season. The referee, Mr. Ray Tinkler of Boston. The ground is very, very hard. It's a beautiful day here, but bitterly cold. The ground very hard, and both teams have been out before the kickoff to test the surface and to try various stunts. Derby County to kick off. Number 9 is John O'Hare. Number 10, Kevin Hector. This is a day for the brave footballer. See how sunny it is from those shadows. And notice Les Green sensibly wearing tracksuit trousers. It's going to be very painful to go down on this pitch. Robson to O'Hare, and there's Hector, number 10. Well, under better conditions, I think Hector might have recovered, had that ball in the net. Then perhaps he would never have had the chance under perfect conditions. Mr. Newton. Kindly finding more. McGovern fouled by McFly then. Hennessy, who's holding this Forest defence together very well indeed. Finding Reese. Carlin to Durbin. Both these teams operating a 4-3-3 system, and Derby midfield trio of Durbin, number 4, number 7 McGovern, number 8 Carlin, one of the best in the country.
Will an electrician please report to the players' tunnel immediately?
Good throw to McFarlane, who's able to come upfield with Mackay so strong behind him. O'Hare. O'Hare tried a shot then, I'm sure he could feel himself losing his footing. McGovern, lovely football by this youngster. That shows you how difficult these conditions are. It was a good save by Hill from McGovern, who hit that ball well. Kept it low. Those are the ones almost impossible to save on a frozen, rather uneven surface. Very good young player, John McGovern. Hinton getting a bit of a tactic stalk before he takes the corner. No doubt that did look like a goal from the other end of the pitch. Roy McFarlane. Very highly rated number 5. Could well make Mexico. Webster leaving it for Hinton. And these are the right tactics by Derby. Alan Hinton hitting that one from fully 35 yards. The Derby have decided that these are the tactics on a frozen pitch. Hit them from long distances and the goalkeeper will be scampering around, trying to keep a footing. Almost impossible for him to do so. That's a good ball. Good ball for Hilly. And this time it's Webster coming across for Derby. 20 minutes from half-time, no score. Winfield. That could well have been the most sensational own goal of the season from number three John Winfield of Forest. Lyons trying to find Hilly. Winfield for Forrest, and a foul on Moore, who's being pushed in the back by McFarland, and I think McFarland is likely to get his name taken for that. Perhaps a little fortunate to get away with it under these strict new instructions. Mr. Tinkler, not a man to take a player's name lightly. Very good referee. Newton with the free kick. Is up for offside anyway, but the referee has given a corner. That's Newton, the man who hit the bar. Quite understandable that the linesman flag when a man is in an offside position, but it's the referee to decide if he interferes with play. More a goal. A good goal scored by Ian Moore, 27 minutes gone. Derby defence got very flat-footed then. Half time, any time now. Hinton to Carlin, and again it's Hennessy for Forest. What a match he's had. Durbin to number 11, Hinton. And again it's Hennessy. Corner kick. Problematical as to whether Derby have enough time in which to take this one. 45 minutes are well up according to our watch. Hinton, it's there! No, it's not! It's off the line again! Hector, the man who almost scored. Newton, the second man who played it off the line. What a sensational ending that would have been. And the whistle goes for half-time. Forest are leading 1-0. Number 11, Ian Moore, the goal scorer. Proving that numbers mean nothing by actually kicking off. The wind, remember, blowing from right to left. Dave Mackay, the Derby skipper. The temperature going only one way, and that's downwards, so this round will be even more tricky. Reese to Newton, and Moore is onside. No, he's not onside, he was very much offside. The free kick's been given. Having a good match for Derby. Reese. Free kick to Forrest. Obstruction by McGovern on Reese. Indirect free kick going to be taken by Winfield. Hinton will find it difficult to turn. Corner kick to Nottingham Forest. Lyons to take the corner. Hennessy, number five, notice, has gone up. And it's Hennessy! What this fellow Terry Hennessy doesn't do. Great man in defence. Tremendous man up front. Webster forward to Carlin. Being held by Newton. Free kick to Derby County, going to be taken by Dave Mackay, their captain. Coming on the blind side of Winfield. Alan Durbin, such a dangerous player. Welsh international came through well then. Behind three defenders, almost equalised. Trip by Hall on number two, Webster. It's Colin Hall. O'Hare, it was just flicked away by Lyons, otherwise it was en route for Hinton. Durbin, McGovern, and McGovern got Newton's boot right in his stomach. And Newton is going to be booked. Newton is going to be booked. Tempers momentarily snapping, but Henry Newton being officially cautioned by the referee Free kick going to be taken by Mackay. Up goes McFarland. O'Hare. Hinton. Durbin. And Hill anticipated that well. He was going down before Durbin's shot. More inside to Hall. That was out of play. Linesman slagged. The linesman on this side, Mr. Goggins of Manchester. The far side, Mr. Warburton, Ulster. McFarlane. Hinton. Kai will probably try a long one into the penalty area. And a corner kick. Derby County now throwing eight men up into the Forest penalty area. Forest have got 10 men back. Crowded area, that penalty area now. Webster again. Hector to Hinton. Just Mackay's position. Carly. Nothing will shake Hennessy, number five, and Chapman, number four, in the Forest defence. Durbin. Khalid unable to pull up on this treacherous pitch. Moore back to Hall for Forrest. Aris. Not Moore. Ingers Lyons, it's 2-0. Barry Lyons has made it 2-0 after an hour's play. And this is a remarkable match day. Forest have been under pressure nearly all the time. They've had two chances. They've taken them both and they lead by 2-0. And so Derby are in real trouble. Hector and Colin, and again it's Newton saving it. And McGovern to Mackay. Fair charge. Derby County's substitute, Frank Wigdall, is an out-and-out striker. It'll be interesting to see whether Brian Clough decides to send him on. Try and pull this game round. It's not Hennessy, it's Chapman who gets it away. showing superb control throughout the whole of this match. Reese. Reese to Lyons. And a foul by Carlin. Carlin and Reese deciding to have the odd word. Number 11, Ian Moore, might decide to have a dip from this distance. Well, that's the distance he's got. He's a bit worried he can't see. It's a corner kick. Number 5, Terry Hennessy coming up. There he is. Corner being taken by Hall. Hennessy. Reese. Bobby Reese, he wasn't far away, was he, with that overhead kick? McFarlane to Hinton. Durbin to McGovern. Farland way up with the attack. Derby willing to take any risk at all to try and get at least one goal back. Carlin. Carlin to Hector. Oh, great bit of football. Wonderful bit of football by number 10, Kevin Hector. A splendid save by Hill. Offside, yes. Goalkeeper and the referee having a little talk. I saw right. I think Hill's got a bit of a bang on his shoulder. The referee was talking to him. Minutes left for play. Derby County in the white shirts in severe trouble. 2-0 down. Reese inside to Hall. What's not a very confident back pass by McFarlane. Always funny on an occasion like that. The outfield player blames the goalkeeper for not coming out, and the goalkeeper blames the outfield player for not hitting the pass with any authority. Carlin seemed to handle that ball, but he's got away with it. Away with nothing against Hennessy. McFarlane. McFarlane to McGovern. McFarlane, number 5 again. Mackay. Wasn't a confident back pass by McFarlane. Was snapping away at his heels all the time. Durbin. Hennessy. No, says the referee. Well over the leg, outstretched leg. Refereeing this match very well indeed, Mr. Tinkler of Boston. Carlin. He's got a lot of room. He's got Webster coming up on his right. This is Webster, number two. Hinton. And that's Hindley who's injured. Taking that ball right in the face. Peter Hindley come back with us. Corner kick to Derby, taken by Hinton. Farland! And Hindley sufficiently recovered to get that ball clear. Devon. Mackay, number six, with a throw for Derby. Ball being held by number two Webster, free kick to Forrest. Just a quarter of an hour left then, 2-0. Derby trail at home, Nottingham Forest. In Chapman, that wonderful combination, the back for Nottingham Forest. Hinton to Mackay. Number 10 is Hector. Alan Durbin. But for all that attacking, no real promise of a Derby County goal. Forest defence has been in superb form. Rees with a throw for Forrest. number 7, Reese. To Moore, offside. Ian Moore. He's a very troublesome customer for the Derby defence. Hennessy is out of the match at the moment, trying to get his shoe back on. But even with his shoe unlaced, he's still very much impossible to beat. Well, nobody's going to hold up the game for Terry Hennessy or anybody else to fasten his shoelaces. Look up to Hinton. Finding Hilly. That's a good one for Moore to chase. And Moore has been penalised quite rightly for pushing McGovern. Nevertheless, it was a very good save by Dave Mackay, whipping the ball right off Moore's toe. Here's McGovern. McGovern once again. Just about a minute, nothing including any stoppages to go, and Derby County are 2-0 down. Ed O'Hare making a back for Hennessy, free kick to the Forest. Hennessy to take the free kick. What a beautifully flighted shot by Henry Newton, so well saved by Green. It's Newton number 6. Carlin, McFarlane buzzing around, joining in the attacks now, almost in desperation, trying to get a goal. Now what, 45 minutes are up for this half, so we're playing the stoppage time, injury time. Moore. Corner kick. Number 8, Barry Lyons to take the corner. If not the last act of the game, one of the last acts. More willing to spend all the time by that corner flag. Linesman flagging a foul by Moore. On Carlin, free kick to Derby. Mr. Tinkler looking at his watches. Carlin to Hinton. Hector. O'Hare. And it's not out of play. Hit the corner flag, which of course is part of the field of play. Unlike the centre flag. Offside given against Carlin. Some of the crowd thought that was the final whistle. Thank you. Free kick to Nottingham Forest, being taken by Hill. And the whistle goes for the end of the match. Nottingham Forest have won this Midland derby by 2-0. Goal scorer number 11 got the first, Moore, and the second one was scored by Barry Lyons, number 8.